जय भारत टू ऑल स्टूडेंट। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड वेक्टर एंड मैट्रिक्स। ओके, सो टिल नाउ वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टू चैप्टर वेक्टर एंड मैट्रिक्स। सो नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर सीक्वेंस एंड सीरीज। ओके ओके, नाउ what is sequence? Sequence is a list of things, usually numbers, that are in order. This is important. Sequence is in order. There are infinite number, but all the number are should be in the order, some basic manner order. This first term is 3, second term is 5, third term is 7, fourth term is 9. Three dot term means this goes on forever. We all know infinite series. Sequence is a list of things, usually numbers. In mathematics we usually use number. There are two types of sequence, one is infinite and one is finite. We all know what is infinite series and finite series. Those who can we can count number of terms, then that types of sequence is called finite number, and those terms or number we cannot count, it's called infinite series. When the sequence goes on forever, it's called infinite sequence, otherwise it is finite sequence. Let's say some of the example, different types of example, and whether it is infinite or finite sequence. So first of all, this is basic 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 up to infinity is a very simple sequence. It's infinite sequence. This is also infinite sequence, 20 25 30 35. First term is a 20. Here this example we can say that 5, 6, 7, 8 up to infinity. It is also a sequence. It is not important that all the sequence has to start with the number 1 or number 0. It can start with any number and goes up to infinite. This sequence is start from 20. Sequence is start from 100. Or let's say 1000. Any number it can start. Now 1 3 5 7, this is a sequence of first four odd number, and this is we can count this sequence. This there are four odd number, so it is a finite sequence. 4 3 2 1 is also a finite sequence, and this is a backward also, 4 3 2 1. Next example is 1 2 4 8 16 32. You can see that every terms is multiply with the double. It's a infinite sequence where every term is double. 2 double 4 4 8 8 to 16 16 to 32 32 into 2 means 64. Next term. So this is infinite sequence where every term is double. A B C D E, this is a finite sequence, and alphabetically 5 letter. This is Fred, is a sequence of letter in the name Fred. This is 4, also a finite sequence. Next is 010101, is a sequence of alternating zeros and 1. Only 2 number are there, 0 and 1, but in our infinite number of there. So now in definition we can say, we have said that sequence should be in order, but what is order? How do we find how do we can get this is in sequence order? So when we say terms in order, we are free to define anything you can work on. Anything to, if you add plus 5 in every number, if you multiply 3 in every number, If you plus 5, then multiply with every with 3 any number. You can divide it with any number 2 by 3 also. Okay, so you can take anything in order to say, but there are in number next term is should be in the order of previous term. It should remain same. Like if you use plus 5 in every term, so then all the terms are plus 5 of the previous term. Okay, so you are free to define what order that is it. Okay, that could go forward or backward also. Okay, or they could alternate also, like this 0101. This is also a order and this is also a infinite sequence. Okay, like this, if you say this example is a sequence, but if you write this example as a in set, so set is just a 0 and 1. Okay, so this is a difference between set and sequence. Okay, notation, you all know how to write infinite series. Okay, like each element separated by comma and then put curly brackets around the whole thing. Okay, and there are infinity in 3 dot. Okay, rule, what is the rule of the forming the sequence, infinite sequence? Okay, there are number of rules and how to find the number of how to find this sequence in the rule. What is the rule of this sequence? Okay, let's start with some examples so you can get the better idea. Sequence like this 3 5 7 9, start at 3 and jump 2 every time. Now we have to find what is the rule of this sequence. Okay, as a formula, this is a 3 pi. Now we want to find what is the 10th term or what is the 100th term. So how do we calculate? We have to write every number 3 pi 7 9 11 13 for find out the 100th number. Okay, or let's say we can use formula to find out 100, 200, 500 terms. What is the 500 term? Okay, so let's start how to convert this sequence into formula. Okay, now 100 term, or let's say n term, where n could be any term number we want. Okay, so we want to find nth term of this sequence. Okay, so what is the rule of this series will be? Okay, you can see that sequence is goes up 2 every time. Add 2, 2, 5 plus 2, 7, 7 plus 9, 7 plus 2 is equal to 9. Okay, so we can guess that the rule is the something like 2 times n. Okay, where n is the term number. Okay, let's first of all test. Okay, so here if we say n is equal to 1, and what is the 2n value? It is a 2. If we say n is equal to 2, here in official original, the first number is 3, second number is 5, and third number is 7. But here we have assumed that rule is 2n. So we get the number like 2, 4, 6 here, but our original number is 3, 5, 7. So it is a, you can see that this 3 and 2, 5 and 4, it is a law of minus 1. So if we add plus 1 in this all the format, okay, so you can get the right result. Okay, so now we add plus 1 in the every time, so our new rule will become 2n plus 1. So now let's test this formula 2n plus 1. If we add n is equal to 1, we get 3. If we take n is equal to 2, we get 5. If we take n is equal to 3, we get 7. So you can see that original term and our formula's term are equal. Okay, so this for sequence formula is a 2n plus 1. Okay, so now our original question, if you want to find 100 term, how do we now it will become simple. If you want to find 100 term, simple, put n is equal to 100 or any number you have to find. Okay, so with this formula, sequence formula, you can get the any term or n its value. Okay, so its 100 term is 2 into 100 plus 1 is 201. Okay, so this is the how do we find formula of the sequence, given sequence. Okay, there are other rules also in this sequence. Okay, now with the help of, we can say that this sequence has a this rule 2n plus 1. Okay, now there are also other sequence also with this number of number also. Okay, let's say, okay, how about odd number without a 1 in them? Okay, this is also a sequence. Now let's say, what is the odd number? 3 5 7 9. Okay, 9, after that 9 23 also. Oh, sorry, this is wrong here. Okay, sorry, this is not about, let's say, forgot this example. Let's say this is a 2n plus 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13. Okay, okay, sorry, they have now wrong. Okay, sorry, okay, this is forgot this example. We have now only 1. Okay, so I try to said that sequence has a number of rule. Okay, you can come out with the different number of rule. Okay, so it is best to say a rule rather than there are not only one rule for the given sequence. There are also will become 2 rule or 3 rule. Okay, now notation. To make it easier for to use the rule, we often use this special style. Okay, x suffix ma n. Okay, this is a n is a term number, and n is the term number, and xn is the term value, and n is the term number, like 100 term, 500 term, 5 term, 6 term. Okay, so for this serial and rule, we can write xn is equal to 2n plus 1. Okay, and now if we want to find 10th term, we can say x is equal to 10, sorry, n is equal to 10. Okay, we can say n x 10 is equal to 2n plus 1 is equal to 21. You can also find x 15. Okay, so let's start some difficult exam. Calculate the first 4 terms of this sequence. This is basic. Okay, this is not difficult at all. Okay, only we have to put n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, and with the help of calculation, we get the answer and we can get the series. Okay, so with the help of series, you can get the formula, or with the help of formula, you can get the series. Okay, so now let's start with some special sequence, types of sequence. Okay, arithmetic sequence. Okay, arithmetic means addition or subtraction. Okay, so in this sequence, we have to write in arithmetic form. Okay, addition or subtraction form. Let's say, what is arithmetic sequence? The difference between one term and the next is a constant. Okay, difference between first term, second term, third or fourth, difference between one term and its next term is a constant. Here difference, this is constant. If we different third term and second term, fourth and third. Okay, and we have to write like this. Okay, let's start with example. This is a sequence 1 4 7 10 11. Here you can see that we have to add plus 3 in every term. Okay, so here rule for our formula will become 3n minus 2. Okay, 3n minus 2. Now we have to write in this sequence in the arithmetic form. So how do we write like this? If let's say we can first term we take as a, then next term will become a plus d. Okay, here a 1 plus 3, d will always will become constant. Then a plus 2d, a plus 3d. So also we can get the this sequence. Okay, so this is the arithmetic sequence. This is our common formula, but we can write this sequence into arithmetic form also, arithmetic sequence also. Okay, here a is our first term and d is the difference between the term. Here you can say that difference between the terms always become, always have to same. Okay, now for this sequence we have to make formula. So how do we make its n terms become xn is equal to a. You can see that here a is same in all the term, a plus d, d is also same, but here what is the coefficient of d? It is a n minus 1. Why? Because our first term is only a. Okay, so its coefficient is n minus 1. Okay, now let's say next our geometric sequence. Okay, in geometric sequence each term is found by multiplying the previous term by constant. In arithmetic we have to difference or add, here we have to multiply. Okay, let's say example 2 into 2 4, 4 into 2 8, 8 into 2 16. Here you can say sequence is a factor of 2 between each number. Okay, so now we have to write this sequence in geometric form. So how do we write? Like this, first term is a, our second term is a into r, our third term is a into r square. Okay, so r is a factor between the terms, let's say common ratio. Okay, 4 divided by 2, here we have r is equal to 2. Okay, so the we can convert this sequence into geometric sequence like this, a comma r square, ar square, ar square and ar cube. R is a factor between the terms. Okay, here r should not be 0. If r is equal to 0, so our sequence will become a 0 0, which is not a geometric or not a sequence. Okay, and if we want to formula out this sequence, we can write xn is equal to, here a is common in all the term, a, r is also common, and ratio is n minus 1 because first term has a no r. Okay, so we can convert any sequence into geometric sequence if it is applied, and after that we can convert geometric sequence into this rule also. Okay, now our next sequence, triangle number. Okay, triangle number sequence is generated from a pattern of dots which form a triangle. Okay, there is called triangle form, pattern of dot. Here first it's common, then we make three dot and make one triangle, then we make six dot. Okay, we can make this triangle. Okay, so it's a pattern of dots, but all the pattern of dots have to become form a triangle. Okay, here you can see that this is a triangle, this is triangle, this is triangle. Okay, this is triangle. Yeah, okay, so all the pattern of dot have to become triangle. So here now this is first term, second term, third term, fourth term and fifth term, and number of dot is our sequence. So here first term there are one dot, in second term there are three dot, in third number there are six dot. Okay, in fourth number there are 10 dot, and in fifth number there are 15 dot.
ओके, सो दिस इज अ सीक्वेंस, इट्स कॉल्ड ट्रायंगल नंबर. ओके ओके, हाउ डू वी फाइंड आउट अबाउट द नेक्स्ट डॉट? इफ यू वांट टू फाइंड अबाउट सिक्स टर्म, हाउ डू वी कैलकुलेट? यू कैन सी दैट इफ वी एड दिस नंबर, नंबर डॉट एंड नंबर, इफ वी एड दिस वी कैन गेट द आवर सेकंड टर्म. नाउ सेकंड टर्म एंड थर्ड नंबर, 3 + 3 = 6, 6 + 4 = 10, 10 + 5 = 15 डॉट. और यू कैन ऑल्सो टेल विथ द हेल्प ऑफ फिगर, हियर वी हैव एड सेकंड रो, हियर दिस ट्राइंगल इज सेम बट फॉर द थर्ड टर्म वी एड थर्ड रो, फॉर द फोर्थ टर्म वी एड फोर्थ रो एंड दे हैव फोर नंबर, वी एड फाइव रो ऑल्सो विथ बिकम सिक्स नंबर रो एंड वी एड सिक्स डॉट. Okay, so fourth term will become 15 + 6 = 21. So it is a rule we can write like this, n into n plus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so we can use any number and we get the answer. Okay, so this is a triangle number. Next is a square number. It is a square, okay, means square like word says. Okay, next number is made by squaring where it is in the pattern. Okay, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, okay, 4 square. Okay, so this is a sequence. It is a called square number and it's denoted by xn is equal to n square. Also, cube number, xn is equal to n cube. Okay, now Fibonacci sequence. This is important. Okay, what is Fibonacci? Okay. Fibonacci sequence is next number is founded by adding the two number before it. Okay, two number before it. Now let's say here we can say 0 and 1. We can take 0 and 1. Okay, now our next term is addition of previous two number. Okay, addition of previous two number. 0 plus 1 is 1. Okay, now our next term is become addition of previous two numbers, so it is 2. Our next term is addition of these two number, 3. Our next term is addition of these two number, it is a say 5. Okay, so this is called Fibonacci sequence. Okay, the second 2 is founded by adding the two number before, 1 + 1. 21 is founded by addition of 8 + 13. Okay, so our rule will become xn is equal to its previous term and previous to previous term, so n minus 1 and n minus 2, xn minus 1 plus xn minus 2. Okay, now this rule is they have said it is interesting. Why? Because its value is depend on previous two term. What is the previous two term? That will depend on the third term. Okay, so this is a Fibonacci sequence. If you want to calculate a term 6, so how do we calculate? x6 is equal to 6 minus 1 plus 6 minus 2, so x5 plus x4. Now if you don't know x5 and x4, you can also take x5 is equal to x4 plus x3 and x4 is equal to x3 plus x2. Okay, so you can also write like this and find out the sixth term in the Fibonacci sequence. Okay, so here this is your today's assignment question. You have to write and upload it in Radianwrite application. Today's lecture is completed.